Yo, what is up, YouTube? Y'all already know I always start off my chest workouts, man, with some dips to hit that lower chest. Get them lower pecs coming in, man. I did two sets of dips, man, just to warm up the lower chest. And then I did some weighted dips. I do not have it recorded. I tried to go to the gym this morning super early. And it was like very, very, very packed. So now, tomorrow morning, I'm going to probably go at 5. So I got to wake up at 4:30. So I'll be there at 5. You know, just to get my recordings in so you guys can see, you know what I'm saying, what I'm doing, how I'm working out. You know what I'm saying? Right here, I did some incline. I don't even know if this is a hammer strength. I guess you can call it that. It's a crunch fitness equipment. I did about 4 sets of these. It was really a quick chest workout. I really didn't want to post this, but I'm just posting for y'all anyway, just to show you guys what kind of chest workout you can get in if you want to get in and get out the gym. Pretty much all you need is something for your lower chest, your upper chest for incline, and then a chest pressing movement. I increased the weight each set. I added a 25 to each side. I have a 45 on each side right now. Then I add a 25 and I add another 25. You know what I'm saying? Just, you know, putting more stress on my upper chest, you know, because I want my upper chest to grow more. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, man, it was tough waking up this morning, dude. Like, I went to bed at 7:30 and I woke up at 5:30. You know, and I went to the gym, but tomorrow morning I'm waking up super early to go work out just because, you know, I need to get up that early and I need to work out. You know what I'm saying? I need to get it in. This set right here, man, as y'all can see, that shit got heavy, but man, I really pushed myself, man. Fun fact, man, if you really want your upper chest to grow, do a lot of incline and do a lot of high incline. Pressing, so a lot of high incline dumbbell press. Depending on if my chest isn't sore in the morning, I'll show you guys way more advanced clips tomorrow, because I'm training back and shoulders tomorrow. So I'm doing arms, of course, because I'm doing arms every day. And then I might add in some more chest work. You know, this morning was just, you know what I'm saying, not that good. It was a good workout, but it could have been way better. Right, so then right here, this is one of my favorite chest pressing hoist machines. As you can see, like, I roll my shoulder blades back as I'm pushing through the palms of my hands to really engage all chest and not like my shoulders or my triceps. I mean, it's a little bit of my triceps, but I'm just trying to focus on nothing but the chest. Nothing but the chest. That's all I'm focusing on is my chest. And y'all already know, man, we doing arms every day. Y'all already know. This day 2 of arms every day. I don't care what y'all gotta say, but guess what? Your boy Steph hitting arms every day. I don't care if they sore. These mullets gotta grow. So that being said, I'm hitting these bad boys every single day. Just keep in mind, I'm doing about 5 to 6 sets. I'm trying to aim for 15 to 20 reps each set. And you can see what weight I'm doing. This weight is it's kind of heavy. Like, it's not light and it's not like medium. It's kind of heavy. It's really stretching the hell out of my triceps. So I just finished up with some of that. Here go these explosive push-ups, y'all. I didn't finish up my chest workout with these. This was like my third chest movement. I did 4 sets of these clapping push-ups. And then I did staggered push-ups. And y'all about to see these staggered push-ups right now. I haven't done these in a while, but man, you can never go wrong with putting a push-up routine to your, you know what I'm saying, chest workouts, man. You can never, ever, never, ever go wrong, you know what I'm saying, doing those things like that. Last but not least, one of my favorite chest finishers is the underhand cable row to hit the upper chest, man. Just a crazy pump, crazy stretch and squeeze. You ain't even gotta go that heavy to do these, man. It just feels so good, man. It feels real good. Rolling your shoulder blades back so you can get nothing but the chest being worked. You know, this is what I like to do towards the end of my chest workouts. You know what I'm saying? And then this say right here, I went a little heavier as well. It's hard, y'all. Like, working out every day ain't easy, man. Doing videos and stuff, people think it's easy doing videos. Like, man, it ain't easy. Sometimes I gotta get, you know what I'm saying, people that I may know at the gym, or like when I was in Milwaukee, you know, I had to get my homeboy, surprisingly, he was working out with me. I had to get him to record me. You know what I'm saying? I was doing the same thing in this clip right here, you know? I had to get him to record me, you know what I'm saying? And he did a good job. I was going kind of heavy here, but you know what I'm saying? But look at the upper chest being worked. Like, look at the muscle fibers. That's all upper chest being worked. All of that is good upper chest. All upper chest. So you got to be keeping in mind with what you're working on. So I hope you guys enjoyed that. That was just a quick chest, simple arm workout. Like I said, I'm doing arms every day. For those who don't know, who haven't watched the last video, I'm doing arms every day. And I'm doing pull-ups every day. So I'm gonna take y'all with me to the crib, because I'm gonna give y'all some advice on macros, meal planning, and discipline. Because the shit is fucking easy. Y'all just make it so complicated, okay? Just got home, y'all, and Lexi made me some pancakes, so. You know I'm finna demolish these hoes, y'all. Y'all already know. So, after I'm done eating, I'm going to go fully in depth with dieting, macros, and things of that sort. Because some of y'all, well, most of you guys need help.
Man, it's simple, bro. As far as your macros, you need to find what food work for you, what carb work for you. Food, carb, protein. The foods... Is the carbs, the fats, and the proteins. Keto, carb cycling, paleo diet, those are all tools in your arsenal. Find which tool benefits your lifestyle and you the most. Intermittent fasting, like I said before, guys, I fast every morning. I work out on an empty stomach every morning with my Herbalife tea. You know, they give me a lot of hella energy and black coffee. I mix those together and I'm good to go. Right? You have to find what works for you. That works for me. Set up, like it's so simple, guys. And if you want to eat one meal a day, 2 meals a day, 3, 4, 5, 6. Like, eating frequent meals doesn't boost your metabolism. Your metabolism is something that you were born with. A fat person metabolism now is not going to go faster if he increases or eat his meals every 3 hours. That's not true. So you have to find what works for you. You have to find the right diet that works for you. If that makes sense. I hope that makes sense. Because it's like it's kind of frustrating when people ask all these questions and they go on these fad diets. You need to go on something that works for you. Greek yogurt for a protein-based snack with some chocolate chips and some fat-free whipped cream. I do that all the time. My two basic meals that I do, my two lean healthy meals I do is a sweet potato or a white potato, ground beef or chicken, hot sauce on my chicken, green beans. And my two shakes, my two protein shakes. If I want to have a treat meal or a cheat meal, burger and fry. Me and the wife, we're going to Applebee's this weekend. They got all you can eat, chicken tenders and ribs. Excuse me, I just farted, but that's beside the point. So, it's simple. So if it's not simple to you and you need help, click that link in the description and hire me as your fucking coach. With that being said, I'm going, y'all. Peace.